Okay, so yeah, we got to be told that UEDA has officially opened a case against Judge Hlophe, against the Speaker of Parliament, against the Speaker of Parliament, against Umkhonto weSizwe, and other political parties. So according to them, they are saving South Africa, but they never open a case against the host, by the way. So yeah, just a reminder. A host who was heard on the video saying kill black people, they forgot. Maybe let me say so. When it comes to hosts, they forgot that they need to defend the constitution, right? They only remember when it comes to Hlophe that they need to defend the constitution. So a host was heard saying anything, and they were very comfortable to have hosts as their member in looking good and regular standing, according to them. Now, they have opened an application, and let me read this in a state. Look, it reads as follows. In the High Court of South Africa, Western Cape Division, or Cape Town, case number 16-70/24, in a matter between Democratic Alliance as the applicant and the Mandlakayise John Hlophe as the first respondent, that is Judge Hlophe, former Judge Hlophe, local Speaker of National Assembly, second respondent, Judicial Service Commission, third respondent, Umkhonto weSizwe, fourth respondent, fifth respondent, are all the political parties there involved or who participated in voting for that. So they say they are defending the constitution. They say part A, kindly take notice that the applicant intend to make an application to this honorable court on 10th of September 2024 or as soon thereafter as counsel may be heard for an order in the following item. I've just told you that they are always defending the constitution so long as doesn't involve anybody close to them, then they are defending the constitution. But once it involves people close to them, then they are nowhere to be found. Thus is the hypocrisy we've been subjected to when it comes to the DA. They say in their application, it is ordered that the applicant be dealt with as one of agency and that the applicant's failure to comply with the uniform rules of court and practice manual be condoned. Hey, DA, my daughter. They are saying, hey, footy DA, they are saying, just because it asks, forget about the rules of the court. Forget, just because it us. Focus on the matter. Oh, I'm going to tell you why I'm saying that is hypocrisy at a highest level. Well, this is what is not hypocrisy. If you are not yet subscribed, what are you waiting for? Come on, good people. Because to subscribe, it is free. To like the video, it is free. To comment in the comment section below, it is free of charge. To click the notification bell, it is free of charge. To share this video, it is free of charge. To watch this video until the end, it is free of charge. Also, good people, I mean, come on, to watch the ads, it's free of charge, and that's how you financially contribute to this YouTube channel. Speaking about financially contribution to the channel, you can join, become a member of this YouTube channel from as little as 20 rand a month. You can also use the Super Thanks button. In case you don't want to do that, guys, there is a way where you can use my media company banking details to donate to the channel, and you know what I'm saying? Will bring you more, and also guys want to buy more equipment. So the power is in your hands. Please do the honorable thing as we proceed. MK Party's application was thrown out of court on basis of technicalities that they did not write what they were supposed to write. DA boldly say, forget about that. Just focus on the merit of the case. I am saying if that happens to be heard in court, it will be double standard, because MK Party's case was rejected on the basis of smaller technicalities. Thereon, it was said, nope, remove this application. How is the Western High Court going to listen to this? But let's proceed. Regarding the outcome of the Part B, the first respondent, Dr. Hlophe, is interdicted from participating in the process of the third respondent, JSC. The second respondent, as any other respondent that opposes the application, shall pay the application's cost, including the cost of counsel scale C. Take notice further that the affidavit of Helen Zille will be used in support of this application. Take notice further that the application has been appointed the address of an attorney of record set to below as the address which will be accepted in accepted service of all processes processes in the application. The applicant consent to serve to service by email to email address Helen Zille. It says Helen Zille. Sorry guys, it's the look, it's these people, the attorney, right? So they give their email address there on, saying that yeah, they, you can communicate with us on that. Then they say about Dr. Hlophe, MK Party, JSC, National Speaker of National Assembly, they are to respond before the 26th of July 2024 application in such notice of address within 8 kilometers of the office of the local registrar of this honorable court, which will accept the notice and service of the process in this proceeding. File your answering David, if any, by 9th of August 2024. That's DA for you. So the chairperson of the DA Federal Council, which is the DA is Federal Council, and then they go on to say that they've got this, they've got that, they've got this. So it's a very long local thing. I'm not gonna be able to read everything that is in here, but the thing that I wanted to highlight is the fact that it has been confirmed. I have it, guys. It's here. It's here. So I will not be able to read everything that you probably appreciate me putting in front. And I will not be able to do so. I'm sorry. Here's the thing. I'm going to ask you this few questions and then I'll exit the house. Do you remember when I said to you, there are organizations in this country that only knows people who violate the laws so long as those people doesn't belong to the DA or affiliated with the DA in any way, shape, or form? As long as that is so, then they know that they need to fight. Here's an example. They went all out, Machela Koko, Brian Mlife, Jacob Zuma, you name them. During Jacob Zuma's time, there were people who called Save South Africa. Now, I don't trust that they saved South Africa. They were there saving South Africa. And, you know, telling us the country's collapsing. Now, the country's collapsing in really much. Where are all those organizations undoing tax, freedom under law, Save South Africa? Just to name a few, where are they? Quiet. Here's a question that you need to ask yourself. How many organizations commented or took actions when a host, clear in a clear video, you are so racist? How many of those organizations stood up and say, what you are doing is wrong, we're defending the law, because what he did then, he broke the law. None of those organizations stood up, right? So tell me, if none of them even issued a public statement about it, do you want to convince me that these organizations really, they want to save South Africa? Or these organizations are now a tool to persecute people who are local, who are to persecute their enemy, under the disguise that they are saving the South Africa, under the disguise that they are freedom under the law, they're defending the Constitution. Why now it is necessary for them, few weeks after Uhos Now, Abohelenzile, they've got suddenly got their strength. They have enthusiasm. They are saving the country. They are saving the integrity of the judicial conduct. But they did not take legal action against the person who says kill African people or black people, to be specific. They never even took a single action. Those organizations were quiet. Do you really think that these organizations are here to save South Africa?